Both interstellar visitors, 3I Atlas and SWAN, remain moving targets. Their unpredictability has fueled waves of speculation, and no shortage of clickbait. In this video, we'll set aside the noise and focus on what has been firmly observed so far, with particular attention to the anomalies that challenge the standard dirty snowball comet model. As of 30th of September 2025, here is where things stand. In July 2025, astronomers detected a remarkable interstellar visitor, 3I Atlas. First identified by the Atlas telescope, its designation marks it as the third interstellar object ever discovered. From the very beginning, its behaviour defied expectations. It brightened rapidly, revealed a strikingly unusual morphology, and even appeared to eject material toward the Sun. A phenomenon that classical comet theory finds difficult, if not impossible, to explain. Mainstream models based on the dirty snowball hypothesis predict that cometary activity should be dominated by sublimation, ices heating and venting as they approach the Sun. Yet 3I Atlas consistently violates these assumptions. For proponents of the Electric Universe EU model, however, such anomalies are not contradictions, but opportunities to observe plasma physics in action. This object is expected to reach perihelion, its closest approach to the Sun, on October 29, 2025, and pass within 1.8 AU, roughly 270 million kilometres of Earth, on December the 19th. Close enough for detailed observation, yet distant enough to pose no threat, 3I Atlas provides a rare window into the behaviour of an interstellar comet in real time. The anomalies of 3I Atlas. Observers have catalogued several features that challenge classical cometary expectations. Firstly, a sun-facing plume. Dust and gas extend toward the Sun, where thermal sublimation should be minimal. Secondly, a CO2-dominated coma. Observations from SPHEREx and JWST reveal unusually high CO2 relative to water. This ratio is rare, even among solar system comets, suggesting a fundamentally different chemistry or an alternative process at work. Thirdly, rapid brightening. Sudden increases in activity and changing coma morphology occur unpredictably as a comet nears the Sun. And fourth, non-gravitational accelerations. Jets, dust motions and fragmentations are inconsistent with sublimation-driven thrust models. Each of these anomalies highlights the limitations of conventional cometary theory, while simultaneously providing a rich dataset for EU model analysis. Electric comets, a conceptual overview. In the Electric Universe framework, comets are not just icy bodies, but electrically charged objects interacting with heliospheric plasma, the Sun's electric field, and surrounding currents. Electrical currents flowing between the comet and the Sun produce glowing discharges, focused jets, and plasma sheaves that shape both the coma and the tail. A striking example comes from NASA's Deep Impact mission to Comet Temple 1 in 2005. While Thornhill and other EU proponents have long argued that the narrow filament-like jets, high-temperature hotspots, and sharply sculpted surfaces observed by spacecraft are far more consistent with plasma discharges than with sublimation alone. Temple 1 revealed phenomena that make perfect sense under the electrical model, yet remain puzzling under the traditional icy snowball view. For example, the coma's shape reflects electromagnetic forces, not just gas dynamics, allowing sunward plumes and anti-solar tails to coexist. Volatile release can be electrically stimulated rather than solely thermally driven, explaining unusual gas compositions and unexpected timing. Viewed through this lens, 3I Atlas's unusual features, its sunward glow, rapid brightening, and CO2-dominated emissions are not anomalies, but natural consequences of electrical interactions with the surrounding plasma. The sunward glow. Hubble images revealed a dramatic plume stretching toward the Sun, 10 times longer in that direction than across. Harvard astronomer Avi Loeb described this as, quote, unprecedented. Why does this matter? Well, according to the standard comet theory, such a feature should not exist. Dust and gas are supposed to be pushed away from the Sun, sculpted by radiation pressure and the solar wind. A sunward plume is, within the classical framework, impossible. Within the electric universe model, this is exactly what we should expect. An electrically charged nucleus, immersed in the heliospheric plasma, develops asymmetric discharges concentrated on the sunlit side. Charged particles then accelerate along local electric fields, guided by the comet's fluctuating charge and its current pathways into the surrounding plasma. The outcome? A brilliant sunward-facing plume alongside the traditional anti-solar tail. Polarimetry, dust under the light. Polarimetry, measuring how light is polarized, reveals the secret of cometary dust. 3I Atlas shows an unusually deep, narrow negative polarization branch. The angles and minima point to large grains made of ice mixed with dark, absorbing material. In the electric universe view, grains with different conductivity respond in unique ways to charging, acceleration and plasma currents. This produces the complex polarization patterns we see, patterns that the classical sublimation model struggled to explain. Even 2I Borisov, the first interstellar comet studied in detail, showed similar properties, though less extreme than 3I Atlas. Together, these observations suggest that interstellar visitors carry dust and ice in arrangements that naturally produce electrical effects, effects conventional models do not predict. Carbon dioxide dominance explained electrically. The CO2-rich coma of 3I Atlas overturns classical expectations. In solar system comets, water usually dominates near perihelion, with CO2 making up only 10 to 20% by comparison. But SPHERE-X and JWST observations show CO2 rivaling or even exceeding water in this interstellar visitor. In the electric universe view, electrical discharges on the nucleus can liberate CO2 far more efficiently than sunlight alone, producing asymmetric plumes at unexpected ratios without invoking exotic ice chemistry. The comet's changing colour strengthens this interpretation. As 3I Atlas brightened, it shifted from bluish hues to a vivid green, the hallmark of carbon molecules excited under electrical stress. Rather than a chemical oddity, this glow is diagnostic, a predictable consequence of a charged body interacting with the heliospheric plasma. Non-gravitational accelerations. Classical comet theory often invokes sublimation-driven jets to explain orbital deviations, yet 3I Atlas exhibits accelerations inconsistent with simple outgassing. The EU model provides a natural explanation. Charged dust and ions accelerated by local electric fields produce the observed motion, acting as a cosmic thruster. Abrupt brightening episodes and filamentary jets follow naturally from plasma interactions, rather than improbable sublimation events. Equally, these can also explain anomalous slowing. The alien gap fill. When mainstream models falter, the void is often filled with speculation about aliens or exotic technology. Some commentators even claimed that the sun-facing plume of 3I Atlas might be artificial illumination, a stretch that betrays desperation more than insight. To be fair, anomalies abound. 3I Atlas also carries an unusually high bulk density and a peculiar nickel-to-iron ratio, both of which pose serious problems for the dirty snowball hypothesis. An object supposedly made of fragile ice and dust should not register such compactness, nor should its metallic signature depart so sharply from solar system comets. These features alone have invited speculation that goes beyond nature. As Harvard astronomer Avi Loeb has provocatively noted, quote, "Perhaps it is natural, but we have to allow for the possibility that it is technological." End quote. Wherever see science fiction, the electric universe model sees physics, plasma interactions, electric fields and heliospheric currents, often natural, testable mechanisms for the very signatures driving alien speculation. Loeb's cautionary what-if may grab headlines, but the EU perspective provides the sober alternative. Comets as active electrical bodies, not interstellar spacecraft. Velikovsky's cometary legacy. In 1950, after an extensive study of mythological sources, Emmanuel Velikovsky proposed that Venus entered the solar system as a comet, possibly ejected from Jupiter or Saturn, and only recently settled into its current orbit. Critics, adhering to the view of a stable, slowly evolving solar system, dismissed his ideas as pseudoscience. Yet, he predicted two specific outcomes. One, Venus would have an extremely high surface temperature, and two, its atmosphere would be dominated by carbon dioxide. Decades later, both predictions were confirmed by space probes. Similarly, Thornhill's electric comet model anticipated features such as filamentary jets, rapid brightening, sunward plumes, and unusual volatile composition long before conventional theory offered explanations. Rapid brightening, electrical avalanche. Classical explanations blame sudden exposure of volatile ices or phase changes. The EU model, by contrast, points to electrical thresholds. As a comet moves into regions of higher heliospheric potential, currents build. Once a critical threshold is crossed, an electrical discharge, an avalanche, ignites surface material, blasting dust and gas into space. 3I Atlas has recently displayed just such behaviour, its brightness surging while its colour shifted to a vivid green. In the EU view, this glow signals the excitation of carbon-bearing molecules under electrical stress, a hallmark of active plasma processes. These outbursts can repeat, appear asymmetric, and form coherent long-reaching jets, all patterns that classical gas dynamics struggles to explain. The Deep Impact debacle. Before NASA's Deep Impact mission slammed a copper projectile into Comet Tempo 1 in 2005, while Thornhill issued several specific predictions based on the electric comet hypothesis. He stated that the resulting crater would be far smaller than expected, and that a brilliant flash, electrical in nature, would occur before the projectile actually struck the surface, outcomes directly at odds with the dirty snowball model. When events unfolded exactly as Thornhill described, NASA scientists were visibly stunned. One confessed on camera, quote, "I'm at a loss to explain it." Matt Finn revisits this in the Thunderbolts episode, Set the Record Straight, showing how the mission inadvertently validated key aspects of the EU electric comet model. As Thornhill observed, quote, "All the things we see around comets fit the electrical model, but don't make much sense in terms of icy snowballs sublimating into space," end quote. And in a remark that has only grown more prophetic with time, Thornhill added, quote, "It is surprising that they continue to be surprised by all the surprises," end quote. 3I Atlas as a live test. If 3I Atlas is electrically active, we can predict evolving coma morphology tied to heliospheric voltage, episodic surges of carbon dioxide and other volatiles, filamentary jets, rapid outbursts, and possible fragmentation, all driven by electrical erosion rather than thermal effects. These predictions are testable with spectroscopy, radio to optical imaging, and plasma diagnostics. Timing of activity relative to heliospheric field changes can confirm electrical interaction rather than mere heliocentric distance. A newcomer joins the stage, Comet SWAN. The sudden arrival of Comet C 2025 R2 SWAN has sharpened the mystery. First detected in September 2025 by the SOHO spacecraft's SWAN instrument, it appeared almost out of nowhere. Already bright and already active, it reached perihelion scarcely hours after discovery. By then, it carried a fully developed tail and a luminosity that slipped neatly through the fingers of sublimation theory. Its path takes it close. Perihelion at roughly 0.5 AU on September the 12th, and Earth's closest approach near 0.26 AU in October. With a long period orbit stretching tens of thousands of years, SWAN is a true wanderer from deep space. Yet, in its behaviour, it mirrors 3I Atlas, sudden ignition, volatile outbursts, and a plasma-dominated tail, signatures of electrical processes that conventional models struggle to explain. Mainstream voices dismiss such anomalies as coincidences or isolated quirks, but a pattern is emerging, and with it, cautious concern. Are we witnessing a chance alignment of two unusual comets, or could they be fragments of a larger hidden swarm now drifting into the inner solar system? If the latter, the consequences could extend beyond astronomy. Is Comet SWAN part of a hidden swarm? Electrically active comets can disturb the solar plasma environment, provoking outbursts from the Sun. On Earth, such changes might cascade through the magnetosphere, producing intense auroras, temporary disruptions to satellites and power grids, and, as some studies cautiously suggest, correlations with heightened seismic or volcanic activity. What we are witnessing may be a small window into a larger, electrically dynamic environment in which comets, the Sun and our planet are more closely connected than previously imagined. Similarities and differences. SWAN vis-à-vis 3I Atlas. Both comets undermine the dirty snowball model. SWAN brightened abruptly near perihelion, its sudden activity pointing to electrical processes as much as solar heating. 3I Atlas showed the same kind of behaviour, becoming luminous only when discharge activity began. The differences, however, are key. SWAN passed much closer to the Sun, where heating effects were stronger, and its near approach to Earth gave astronomers detailed views of its tail and plasma structures. 3I Atlas, by contrast, was monitored for months before it reached the inner solar system, revealing electrical activity at great distances, well beyond the reach of solar heat. This distinction highlights why SWAN's late discovery leaves open questions, while 3I Atlas provides clear evidence of electrical activation far from the Sun. Why these visitors matter? 3I Atlas offered something unprecedented, an interstellar sample observed in real time, with chemistry, morphology and dynamics that defied every expectation. Sunward plumes, polarimetric signatures, non-gravitational accelerations, rapid brightening and CO2 dominance all reflected the behaviours long predicted by the electric universe model. Now, with the arrival of SWAN, the pattern is reinforced. The significance of these comets lies not in their individuality, but in their shared defiance of conventional expectations. One anomaly may be dismissed, two form a pattern, and in science, patterns demand attention. The electric universe does not label them anomalies, it sees evidence. Together, 3I Atlas and SWAN pose a question that mainstream astronomy has struggled to confront. What if comets are not inert leftovers, but active participants in a charged solar system? What if their behaviour is not random, but electrical? If so, the dirty snowball model is not so much incomplete, it's obsolete.